Superman designs an invasion strategy for all superheroes to take over Apocalypse in order to prevent the battle from spreading to Earth. Darkseid observes through Cyborg as Superman outlines the strategy, and he discovers their plot. A swarm of fresh parademons attack the heroes as the plan is put into action. After 2 years, Superman and a frail Raven plead for help from a drunk John Constantine and a despondent Etrigan in an empty bar. The group is subsequently ambushed by parademons, and they barely manage to defend themselves. When Constantine questions Superman as to why their plan fell through, Superman replies that it did so because Darkseid discovered it and launched a new army of parademons, hybrids of parademon and doomsday creatures, in response. The invasion killed most of the heroes, but Darkseid had plans for those who did, connecting Batman to the Mobius chair to make him his servant, injecting Superman with liquid kryptonite to render him powerless, and making the other heroes his minions. Raven then grills Constantine vehemently on his decision to flee the scene of Zatanna's murder. Constantine explains that he doesn't know why either. He simply left without giving a reason, and he still doesn't know. The group enters Big Ben to come up with a new strategy, and Superman hints that they will need Constantine's assistance in finding Damian Wayne. The gang teleports to Nepal after some difficulty, where they are ambushed by Lady Shiva and the League of Assassins. Damian breaks up the battle and identifies himself as the new leader of the Demon League. Damian is necessary, according to Superman, in order to free Batman from Darkseid's control, or, in the event that they are unsuccessful, to kill him. In an effort to stifle Trigon inside of her, Raven starts to strain more and more. Raven develops a backup plan with Constantine to kill her in order to stop Trigon from fleeing as she becomes weaker. Three Reapers are sent into the Earth by Apocalypse to collect the core. To meet Lois Lane and gather further support for their scheme, the group travels to Belrive. They encounter Harley Quinn there, who has taken charge of the Suicide Squad since Amanda Waller's death. Two squads will attack the Reapers to distract the parademons from Apocalypse, while Darkseid prepares to personally invade Oa, according to Lois's plan to destroy the city. They will attack LexCorp and utilize the teleporter there to get to Apocalypse while the parademons and Darkseid are preoccupied. The power generator will be destroyed, and Apocalypse will also be destroyed. Shazam leads the assault on the huge Wall Reaper while Orchid and the other Bat family members go after one of the Reapers. While Lois observes that no parademons have been called off Apocalypse, Harley and Captain Boomerang transport the remaining individuals into LexCorp through a vehicle. Swamp Thing is persuaded to assault the neighboring Reaper by Constantine, who then plans to project himself to the Congo. The parademons are called to defend the Reapers, proving that the strategy is successful. Darkseid personally invades Oa as planned to obliterate the Green Lantern Corps. The team passes through LexCorp, losing Lady Shiva and Cheetah in the process, and reaches the top level with the Apocalypse forces occupied. When they approach Lex Luthor, he persuades them to spare him so that he can continue to assist them. Lex arms the teams with kryptonite weapons in order to fight the parademons, and gives Superman his war suit in order to help him keep up in the fight. The team split up, with Lois, Lex, and the remaining Suicide Squad members, Harley Quinn, Captain Boomerang, Bane, King Shark, and Black Manta, staying behind to guard the teleporter. Meanwhile, Superman, Raven, Damian, Constantine, and Etrigan will go to Apocalypse to destroy the generator. Lois kisses Superman goodbye as the group teleport to Apocalypse. Unfortunately, the new Furies, cyborg versions of Hawkman, Mera, Starfire, Martian Manhunter, and Wonder Woman, notice the squad. As a result of the struggle, Constantine is able to seize Diana's lasso of truth and free her from Darkseid's influence after Wonder Woman kills Etrigan. After receiving mental healing, Wonder Woman repels the cyborg Furies while Constantine and the others move closer to the generator. The Congo Reaper is successfully destroyed by Swamp Thing, but the Reaper teams are ultimately overpowered by the parademons and killed. Batman informs Darkseid that the Resistance is attempting to attack Apocalypse in the meantime. On his way back to Apocalypse, Darkseid destroys Oa and the Lanterns. The team arrives at the generator and is shocked to discover that the Flash serves as its power source. Constantine allows Flash to relax when they unhook him. Constantine observes Flash's memories as he works and learns that Flash is to blame for everything because of the Flashpoint. They can't blow up Apocalypse without a generator. Therefore, they must alter their strategy. They then make the decision to proceed in search of Batman towards Darkseid's throne. From there, they locate Cyborg, who is linked to Apocalypse's mainframe, and heal his mind to release the cyborg Furies. Batman is ordered to assassinate Damian by Darkseid when he appears. Batman obtains the upper hand, but decides against killing his son after remembering the night his parents were killed. Damian blocks the Omega beams that Darkseid uses to murder him, and as a result, Damian is killed. Trigon tries to break free of Raven as she loses control due to her grief over Damian's passing. Trigon is set free after Constantine removes the jewel from Raven. Trigon rejects Constantine's offer to serve as a host, so he takes control of Superman and rids him of his kryptonite. John Constantine is killed by a Trigon-possessed Superman, who also attacks Darkseid. In the meantime, the Parademons invade LexCorp to get back to Apokolips. The squad battles waves of Parademons while equipped with kryptonite weaponry, until they are forced aboard the teleporter and set off the self-destruct. Lois makes an effort to have one last conversation with Superman as the clock winds down, and the group is being engulfed by the forces of Paradoom. Before the LexCorp tower blows up, Lois broadcasts a final "I love you" and farewell to Superman through his battlesuit. Superman, who is devastated by her passing, manages to distance himself from Trigon, and Darkseid captures Trigon. As Raven gets better and revives Damian, Superman turns on Darkseid. Zatanna apologizes for casting a compulsion spell on John 2 years ago, in order to preserve his life in the event that the Justice League's invasion plan fails when John awakens in an afterlife with her. She is pardoned by Constantine, who afterwards reawakens in Apokolips. He intends to trap Apokolips and Darkseid by having Cyborg activate a boom tube that leads nowhere. Raven and Constantine release Trigon and use him to combat and divert Darkseid in an effort to save as many people as they can. Cyborg opens a boom tube for everyone to escape, teleports the Parademons back to Apokolips, and then stays behind to destroy Apokolips. Trigon and Darkseid are imprisoned in the boom tube as it destroys Apokolips and engulfs it. Superman, Batman, and Wonder Woman return to the Titans Tower and discover that the Reapers have taken too much of the Earth's core, bringing about impending doom if they can't undo it. Batman claims that even if the damage is repairable, 1 billion people will die before the Earth is repaired. Superman makes an effort to encourage the remaining heroes to persevere, but he is met with silence. The defeated Flash is then approached by Constantine, who requests that he clear the board. Flash hesitates and claims that he made a vow to Iris that he would never time travel again out of fear for his safety. Constantine begs, saying that anything would be preferable than the situation right now. Flash cautions him that it could result in another flashpoint and change everything. Although Constantine acknowledges that things won't be ideal, he persuades him that they will still succeed. Motivated, Flash uses the Speed Force to flee, and a bright light that follows him devours the rest of the world's heroes.